In our earlier discussion, we have discussed the construction and working of calomel electrode. In our present discussion, let us determine the electrode potential of unknown electrode using standard calomel electrode. The unknown electrode whose potential has to be determined is coupled with standard calomel electrode. Let us consider zinc as an unknown electrode which is coupled with standard calomel electrode. This cell is diagrammatically represented as here zinc is dipped in zinc sulfate connected to the voltmeter and calomel electrode is also connected to the voltmeter. This cell which was diagrammatically represented can also be represented as zinc / Zn2 plus. This is the salt bridge Hg, Hg to Cl to Cl minus. This is nothing but representation of calomel electrode. Proper measurements of electrode potential of zinc electrode can be made only when zinc is connected to negative terminal of voltmeter and standard calomel electrode is connected to positive terminal of voltmeter. This is a trial error method. So there is no given rule that zinc should be connected to negative terminal and calomel electrode should be connected to positive terminal of voltmeter. So initially when calomel electrode was connected to negative terminal of the voltmeter and zinc was connected to the positive terminal of the voltmeter did not show any reading. So the connections were interchanged. Zinc was connected to the negative terminal and calomel electrode was connected to the positive terminal of the voltmeter. When this was done, the voltmeter showed some fluctuations. That is nothing but it shows some readings and that reading is nothing but cell potential and it was recorded. Since zinc is connected to the negative terminal of the voltmeter, zinc electrode acts as anode and since calomel electrode is connected to the positive terminal of the voltmeter, it acts as cathode. As we all know that EMF or cell potential is given by E cathode minus E anode. Here cathode is nothing but calomel electrode and zinc electrode acts as anode. By substituting this here, the above equation will become E standard calomel electrode minus E zinc. By equating to zinc, we get E zinc equals E standard calomel electrode minus E cell. The standard calomel electrode potential is known and is constant, whereas E cell we have already measured. By substituting for standard electrode potential and cell potential, we can determine the zinc electrode potential. The same procedure, we can determine the electrode potentials of all unknown electrode by coupling it with standard calomel electrode. Thank you.